Hey guys, Kimberly Olson here, also known as the Gold Digger Girl, coming in for a Gold Digger Daily. Happy Monday! I hope you guys are doing awesome. I hope you guys had an amazing weekend and are ready to crush this week and have some fire in your business and in your life and what you're focusing on to have it be an awesome, awesome week. So we're going to talk about what you have one of, okay? Let me know how you guys are doing. Let me know where you're tuning in from and let me know how your hair is. It is super humid here already. It's been raining. So I got some big hair. See, everything's bigger in Texas. I'll tell you guys a funny story really quick. Scott and I are from Michigan and that's where we met. We met in the YMCA. I worked there and I was working out and he had the disinfectant. So I was like, oh my gosh, he's so cute. Can I borrow the disinfectant? And no, he asked me to. And I was like, here you go. And then I was like, oh, I've seen you around. So we started talking, went out to lunch and then we went out on a date that weekend. History, obviously, fell in love right away. So we flew to Texas to interview and we landed in the evening and went straight to the rodeo. Who's been to the Houston rodeo? It's a big deal. Like it's a whole ordeal. It goes on for like weeks. So our friends were there and they're like, come meet us at the rodeo. So we fly in and we get, okay, so it was April and in Michigan, it was still cold, right? Like my hair was straight and it was looking good. So we get there and we get the rental car and we drive to the rodeo and I go in the bathroom because we've been driving. My hair, it was not straight anymore. It was like that gross where it, like the straight starts unstraightening and it looked awful. And I was like, oh my gosh, we can't move here. We can't move here. I can't like go around with hair like this. So then the next day I washed my hair and then I just did it from scratch and I let it be curly and it was fine. And I was like, okay, we can live here now. I literally like came that close to not moving because I couldn't straighten my hair. I was a lot younger then, a little more on the immature side. So that's my funny hair story. Okay, you have one of these, guys. You have one of these and this is a message for you, but it's also a message to share with your team. Cover this in the next team training. You have one upline. Oh yeah, you have one upline. And if you think that upline is going to be reaching out to hold you accountable and check on you and see how you're doing every day with your goals, you are wrong. And if your upline is doing that, she's doing you a disservice because she's spoon feeding you. So a really great thing to do is to remind your new recruits, remind your team, have a meeting and say, guys, I just wanna let you guys know, remember, there's a bunch of you, which is such a blessing, but there's one of me. You have one upline. It's your job to check in with your upline, okay? So what you can do is just give them a little update. Send them a little voice memo. Hey, today I had a win. I made a new connection. The person is, you know, checking things out right now. Maybe I'll get them in a chat with you. I'm so excited, right? Give them a little update. Maybe it's, hey, you know, today was a rough day. I had some personal stuff come up. Didn't get to what I wanted to today, but my plan is to double my efforts tomorrow. So you're gonna still communicate with your upline all the time, but you are not expecting them to reach out to you. I had a girl who I hadn't talked to and she said, yeah, I thought you would be checking in with me a little because she was not very active last month. And so I had reached out to her. I'm like, hey, like what's going on? Like something up? And she said, oh yeah, I expected you to check in with me more. And I was like, well, it's not going to happen. So I'm not going to be mean about this, but I'm going to let you know that it's your job to reach out to me. It's your job to check in with me. And I've also had people, I kid you not, and maybe you've done this before, so you need to give yourself a little slap there on the wrist. I've had people reach out to me and say, I need to get on a call with you because I need you to motivate me. Oh, hell no. I'm not going to be getting on a call with anybody to motivate them. This is your business. You guys, if you were in real estate or I don't know, like had a restaurant, you wouldn't like go expect somebody to motivate you. You would just get out there and do it, right? Like if you're not motivated, then you're either your why isn't strong enough. You are letting excuses and procrastination get in your way, which I'm actually going to do a podcast on that right after this. So maybe you guys can come tune in on that. It's going to live stream tomorrow on my business page. So you can wait for it then. But you guys hear my point, okay? If you are needing your upline to motivate you, you are misusing that person in your life, okay? Your upline is there to inspire you and coach you and love on you, but you need to reach out to your upline and start that conversation and update them and not expect them to motivate you, okay? If you wanna say, hey, I would love to get on a call because this is what I did and I set up, I have my goals and I want to support, some support on how to make that happen, your upline's going to be pumped to spend time with you because you are actually thinking about your business and you have goals. There are a lot of people on your team that do not have goals, okay? So use your upline's time wisely. Remember that they have a whole team. So don't be shy is my point. Some of you are afraid. I've had people who are like, well, I didn't want to bother you. I'm like, I'm your freaking upline. Come bother me. That's what I'm here for. You're my priority. All those other people that I love to help, they go in the back burner. You're my priority. You're in my team. And I promise you, your upline feels the same way. If you have an upline that you reach out to, hi guys, and your upline says, they don't respond, they don't get back to you, they don't help you, then you need to go get a new upline. So you just go up, pull up your back office and go. Contact the company and be like, hey, I need some support. Who's above my upline? And you go all the way to the top, my friend, because their job is to help you be successful and be there for you when you need that support. Does that make sense? You initiate the conversation. They will be there to support you on your journey to reaching your goals, to guide you, educate, inspire you. But they're not there to answer your dumb questions about, you know, okay, so if I want to do this thing, and I'm not choosing to Google it or go on YouTube because I'm being lazy and I just want you to answer it. Will you answer it for me? That's like, I shouldn't use the word D-U-M-B because I don't like that word, but you know what I mean? Like, you don't want to be misusing your upline. Okay. Be thankful for them that they're in your life. Be so excited that they're there to help you. And that's awesome. And if you're on the receiving end and you're the upline, and or you're planning on growing a team, this is a good lesson for you, you guys. You should not be checking in with your team every day. You should not be bending over backwards because you know what will happen? You'll get burnt out. I've seen it happen, okay? You don't wanna get burnt out. Teach your team to come to you. Have a weekly format such as a team call where they can all come together and collectively you can address certain things to save yourself time. Create a post in a team page if you're getting common questions from people. Like Lindsay says on her team, if it's been asked twice, we are making a video, Kimberly, because we don't need to be keep answering the same questions, right? That's what it's all about. It's making sure you guys don't get burnt out as uplines, and it's making sure you as the downlines go connect with your upline. They want to hear from you. You are not bothering them. But always, guys, if it's a tactical question like, how do I put this order in? I don't know how to do an order. Don't just go ask them questions like that, that you could Google or go watch a video on. That's just being lazy and that is misusing their time. You want to think to yourself, what could I ask them to grow my business? How could they help me? I've got some ideas I want to do. I want to run it by them. That's the kind of stuff you want to be asking your upline for, okay? I hope that makes sense. Okay, no one wants to get burned out. We want to feel awesome and motivated and have excitement in our businesses and be pumped about leading our teams and be so, so happy and grateful we have our uplines too, okay? So I will see you guys at 8 p.m. Central back on my business page for an awesome training of something great that I can't think of what it is right now, but it's gonna be awesome, and I'll see you there. Have a great rest of the day. Bye.